Guys, today I've got a great one for you. It's going to be the best cold call script in the country. This is going to be advanced cold calling for anybody that's sitting in a dealership this winter that's thinking, man, I need some more sales. I'm going to give you, here's the test, here's the answers to the test. I'm going to give you the script to use. All that I ask you to do is chill out, watch the whole video, because I'm going to drop some bombs on you and show you how to literally pick up the phone, A, go to your internet department, go and grab out of your CRM a customer list of people that have purchased from your store 2 years ago and back. So if it's 2020 January, I want you to go to 2018 in January and ask, hey, I need a list, I don't care what month it is, from anybody and everybody that's bought in our store 2 years ago. I'm gonna give you how to take that customer, make them want to buy from you, and do it quick, okay? People will not tell you no. They can't tell you no, not to this script. I'm gonna give you a three-way script, not only to keep them on the phone, but also how to get them interested in one of three things. Now listen, when we do cold calling, what is the purpose and the goal of a cold call? It's to get them to bite, okay? Listen, the sale can't be closed until the sale's opened. So your job as a salesman is to start opening up the sale from a candidate that isn't in the market, but you're going to create them to want to be in the market. Whose job is it to create the interest? Yours. And if you create the interest, what happens? Then they have desire, and then they take action. So let me share this with you. First of all, I'm gonna run a fast script with you, and A, if you want the paper script on this, do me a favor, send me a text message, 918-210-0254, 918-210-0254. I got the whole paper script on this. Shoot me a text, I'll send it over to you. You got it in front of you, rock and roll. But I just kind of wrote down some notes that I'm gonna follow. I know this on my heart, it's tattooed, I use it all the time. If your store doesn't want to, or you don't want to use all three of these, hey, just grab one or two of them. That's fine. But the script works 100% of the time, and it converts customers like I've never seen. If you make 10 cold call phone calls, and you were to get a hold of 10 people, 7 of them would be interested in this. And I'll tell you, at those odds, man, that's crazy, okay? So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start out with the advanced cold calling script. First of all, number one, when we call them, right when they pick up the phone, you always wanna talk about like familiarity. You wanna talk to them like you already know them. This stuff, you sitting in a chair and being like, oh, this is Andy from ABC Motors. Yeah, I just wanted to, bah, you get a dial tone. They're done with you. Listen, talk to them like they're your buddy, okay? So what happens when I call somebody? Do I sound like a telemarketer? No. When I negotiate car deals, do you think that I sound like a car salesman? Absolutely not. I talk to customers like I'm an investor, like I'm their advisor. Okay? Then they trust me to spend their money with me. Listen, they've dealt with the car salesman before. I don't sound like one. So do you know what? They pass go and do business with me on the spot, where when you sound like a car salesman, guess what? They'll tell you no and walk away. You need to sound like who? Somebody that they like talking to on the phone. So that needs to be somebody they have familiarity with. So calling them. Hey, let's just say I'm calling Barbara. Hey, Barbara, what's going on? How you doing? That's how I start my cold. Listen, and you may say, Andy, that don't sound professional. Listen, professional people get hung up on. People that are their friends don't get hung up on. Think about it. What is it that you want? You want to get interest. How are you gonna get interest? You're gonna have to sound like somebody that they don't wanna hang up on, okay? So watch this. Hey, how are you doing, Barbara? Look, this is Andy. I just wanna talk to you for a quick sec. Familiarity. How you been? What's going on? Whatever it is you say, just come out of the gate, find something you feel comfortable with. Hey, Barbara, what's going on? This is Andy. How's your day going? Whatever it is, just come out of the gate with something you feel comfortable with, like you were calling your buddy. That's rule number one. Part of this script is, when I say, hey, how are you? I'm basically telling you, you fill in the gap here. Talk to them and greet them like you already know them. Hey, Tom, what's going on? This is Andy. How you doing today? I'm doing great. Who is this? I'm glad you asked. And guess what? Now I'll go into line two, which is going to be this. This is Andy from ABC Motors. I know you're probably busy, so I'll make this quick. Is that okay with you? What do you think they're going to say? No? No, they're going to say, sure. It's always the answer they give, right? Follow me. This is Andy from ABC Motors. I know you're probably busy. You're basically telling them, I know that you don't want to talk to me. Hey, I know you're probably busy. This is only going to take a second, okay? And they're going to say, okay. I'm going to tell you this. You get them on the phone and you roll with this quick. Hey, Bob, what's going on? This is Andy. How's your day? Man, my day's okay. Who is this? Hey, this is Andy from ABC Motors. I know you're probably busy, so I'll make this quick. Is that okay with you? Sure. Hey, this is Andy from the Chevy house down the street. This is going to be quick. Are you okay if I make this fast? Whatever it is, you want to have it very prepared in a way that you feel comfortable with it. But it's got to be on these guidelines. Now let's get to the good stuff. The first two sentences, it isn't so you can be a second-rated version of me. It's so you can be a first-rated version of yourself. But you have to sound familiarity, right? You have to sound like they're familiar with you. And then two, you got to say these words that, yeah, this is me. And then number one, I know you're busy, so I'm going to make this quick. Is that cool with you? They're going to say, yeah, then you're going to rock and roll. We're going to three now. This is where it gets fun, and this is where you can start hooking them, okay? Awesome. The reason for me calling is that three things just happened today, and I wanted to reach out to you as one of our valued customers to let you in on it. The first is, now watch. Did you see that? Did I pause? No. Don't give them a chance to cut you off. Look, I've got something for our valued customers. Let me explain to you what it is. The first, and you're right here. Rates are dropping. Look, let me tell you this. Rates are dropping better than ever. I don't care if they're high or they're low. Rates are dropping. Do I know what kind of rate they got on their last car? I don't need to know. I make a simple statement. Rates are dropping. Now, what do you do from there? It's simple. You give an example of somebody that dropped their payment and that did business with you. Your goal is here is to fish, okay? So, number one, hey, listen, Johnny, rates are dropping. Let me explain what that means. Miss Tammy came in here last night, right? She bought a car from us 3 years ago, just like you did. Long story short, she didn't want to buy another vehicle. She just wanted to refinance hers, keep driving the same car she has now, and have a lower payment. So she came back in. Guess what happened? We refinanced the car for her. We lowered the payment $100. She's on her way home. Listen, that may be what you're interested in. Secondly, right, our used inventory's low. What that means is let us buy yours, go home in a newer or brand new vehicle with maybe, watch the word maybe, even lower payments, but definitely more warranty so that your cost of ownership will be way less. That way each year you'll save money. Listen, so secondly, look, here's what we want you to do. We want you to sell us your car, buy a new car with more warranty, and probably maybe even get a lower payment. And guess what? That's what we're doing. Number three is simple. Maybe we have some maintenance stuff that needs to be done on your car. Look, you've had your car for 2 years, 3 years now, right? I mean, how many miles you got on it, Cindy? Cindy's got 48,000 miles. I'm like, Cindy, look, you drive an Audi, you got 48,000 miles. I know the maintenancing on Audis. You're getting into that zone where it's time to start spending money. Let me ask you this. What if I took your car, gave you top dollar for it, right? Allowed you to trade into a newer vehicle under full warranty. You didn't have to fix any of that stuff. I potentially, maybe, could even lower your payment, and you didn't have a first payment due for 3 months from now. So through the holidays, you could save big. Would that be something you're interested in? So Cindy, here's what I'm asking you, right? It's real simple. 80% of our customers, what do people like to do? What everyone else is doing. Social proof clothes. Cindy, listen, 80% of our customers are pass and go and rocking and rolling. This is what I want to ask you, right? Which one of these are you most interested in? Would you be interested in just refinancing your car, keeping the same? Would you be interested, right, in trading your vehicle in, getting a newer vehicle with lower miles, full warranty, maybe a brand new car, maybe lowering your payments, or maybe you got some cost of ownership issues that you have to fix. Maybe the last time you're in your service station, the guy said you needed tires on it, right? Guess what? Don't spend that money. Don't. I'm still going to give you top dollars in spite of any of that being done. And guess what? I'll take care of it. Which one of these are you most interested in? All they have to do is say one word. I like the refinance, the lower payment thing. Awesome. So what you're telling me is love to get a lower payment, right? Yeah. Okay, cool. So this is real simple. I'm slammed this morning, but I've got some availability in the afternoon. When is going to be the best time for you to come in? Everybody's taking advantage of this, so we got to move quickly, like why the GMs, the management staff, and everybody is putting all the money in these trades, right? There's going to be a time where they're going to stop. So now why they're hungry and their bellies are, you know, really just hungry to earn business and make deals, you need to decide when you can make it, and I mean like not tomorrow, not the next day, but like tonight, okay? And here's what I'll tell you. No matter what choice they pick, the deal is that now there's genuine interest. You went and you took a customer that was literally not interested in buying a car, and you pointed out some things that gets their mind moving, okay? Why do you think there's commercials on TV? There's commercials on TV to get people in the market to want to buy something. That cell phone, right? Free cell phones, $49 a month, come down to AT&T. What do you think happens with those people? Well, they go down, they end up leaving with a $1,000 iPhone and a $250 a month iPhone payment. Your goal is you want them to get emotional. You want them to come into the store and find something they fall in love with and make a deal with them. And here's the beautiful thing. Everybody's talking about internet shoppers, internet shoppers, internet shoppers. Listen, I'm gonna make another video how to handle that person. It's easy, but this person, are they in the market? No. Have they been internet shopping? No. Are you getting the chance to really set up the sale and do a good job? Maybe make yourself some good money and take care of a customer? Yes. Cold calling is where it's at. These people have already spent money in your store. They're dying to do it again. Listen, this advanced cold call script is sick. It will help you so much. Send me a text. Let me send you the cold call script. You try it on your own, and guess what? Remember, 2 years or older list. That's what this is made for. It'll kill it in the business, and 7 out of 10 will show interest and convert. Probably 5 of them will set an appointment with you, and I bet 2 or 3 will buy. Well, so that means this. If you could get a hold of 30 people a day on a cold call script, you would sell 9 cars. And if you don't believe it, you're right, it won't happen. But if you do believe it, I promise you this. I didn't make the most money selling cars per year not pulling stuff like this off. While everyone else is staring out the window, hoping for a good year, you can assure it. Have a great day, guys.